Okay, so we have a very special video today, and we have a student success story for you. Carolina from Brazil was very, very kind to decide to share her story with you guys so that you can learn from her success and hopefully be successful yourself. So, Carolina, can we just start off by you giving some just background information about yourself, just to introduce yourself to everybody?
Yes. Hi, Chris. Thank you. You were great. I just wanted to say thank you right from the start. My name is Carolina. I'm from Brazil and I'm applying for a Canadian visa. So I did the general training IELTS.
And can you tell people a little bit about your IELTS experience? So what
Yeah.
scores did you get? What struggles were you having? And what scores did you end up getting?
Okay, well, I did two tests. So one of them, the first one was in July this year, 2017. And right from the start, I knew that my problem was writing, but I kind of got a little bit scared of the listening because I knew that I had issues with spelling. So I knew that that the listening is just like everything together, you know, so you have to listen and you have to also write the word correctly. So the first test I did on listening, I wasn't really good. I didn't really read the other spaces, so I just got lost. And then like five questions or three or five questions I just lost. So then I really got freaked out with listening that I didn't really think, I didn't really thought it was my issue, but then I just focused on listening on the first one. And speaking, I just went with the flow. I thought I would do okay. I thought I would get a seven. And reading all of the tests I did, I got above seven. So I kept doing them. And then writing was just like, okay, I think I can do this. And then I didn't really practice too much. I did four essays, but by myself. Everything was by myself. And then, okay, let's do this test. And I got 8.5 on listening, 8.5 in reading. 7.5 in speaking, and then a 6.5 in writing, and then all I could see was that 6.5.
Very, very typical scores. Very,
Yeah.
very typical. It's normally reading and listening are, very,
Yeah.
very high, and then speaking a little bit lower, and then writing a little bit lower still.
Yeah.
Why do you think that was? Why do you think that someone just listening to you and the fact that you got 8.5 in reading and 8.5 in listening, why do you think writing was a problem?
Well, because of the feedback, obviously. I think reading and listening, you can just go there and then see the scripts and then see what's your mistake. And the two of them that you don't get feedback when studying alone, is writing and speaking. So I think that's the direct consequences. I thought I could do it on my own, and then I'll just go and see what I can do. But then I saw that I tried actually before I did the other test, I tried getting it remarked because I thought, oh, just a 0.5 that I need, maybe they'll give it to me and I don't have to do the test again. But it took like 10 weeks and then the result came back and changed. Then okay, I'll have to do this again. Then I didn't really have much time. I got the results that the marking wasn't unchanged in 15 of July of October. So the test day was the 2nd of December, and I had this trip already planned and a surgery planned too. But I just okay, I'll just focus on writing and a little bit of listening. I did like a test each week, so I was actually worried that my score was going to go down in listening. So I just kept that. And then on the final week, I did a one test on reading again, and it was okay. So I was pretty confident on the other ones, because if you've done it once, you really know the test. So I knew that I had to focus on writing. And then the first thing I did was getting an IELTS questions, and I got it marked by a teacher. So I did the test one and test two and got it marked. But I kind of took a long time to get it marked. And then this was like in the beginning of November. And then I said, okay, I have to do something because the time is ticking. And I just wanted to get the seven that I needed. But then I have to know what mistakes I'm doing before that. Mm-hmm. So, and I wanted to do it on the time. And then I just stopped worrying about the time and just did the essay and got it marked. Mm-hmm. And then I got a seven on task one and a six on task two. Okay. Then I knew that test two was, it's got more weight. I don't know how you say it. It's worth two times a test one. Yeah. So I knew I needed to focus on test two. And then I read the modal answer that came with that. And then I tried to do another set of essays. So I did task one again and task two again. And then on task one, I got a seven again, and on task two, a 6.5. That was the score I got at the end of the first test, too. So I just wasn't really getting better. Mm-hmm. So then my husband did the test the first time, and then he was the one that knew your website, but he's kind of lazy, and then he only studied like 2 weeks before the exam, and then I just knew about your site like 2 weeks before, and then I just looked at it back then in July. And then I tried doing something, what I believed, what you were saying. But okay, then I got that 6.5. And anyway, so then I went back to your site, and then miracle happened, and your Facebook ad appeared, and with the $1 course on mm-hmm. the writing test too, I was trying to get better. So then, okay, I'll do this. And it was right in the middle of my trip, so I had to do your tests and manage to do things my trip anyway. And then, so it was really good because it kept me focused. Mm-hmm. I'm sure that if I didn't have that course going on, I would just give myself a break for 1 week, but it was really important because back then it was like 2 weeks for the test. So mm-hmm. I really needed to get better because I didn't have the score I needed, and I wasn't doing it on the time. So that was really worrying me. I I'm free to do what I want. I'm taking more time than I would have on the test, and I'm still not going, no, I'm not getting the seven that mm-hmm. I needed. So what was like mind-blowing for me at that point was then on the first lesson you said that we should get our task remarked, mm-hmm. marked, not remarked. And then you said, go and look at your mistakes and practice and get stronger on those things. So I went back and looked at it. And I saw that I was making spelling mistakes, preposition mistakes, and I saw that I was putting too much ideas on one paragraph. Mm-hmm. So I focused just one idea, one example, explaining that example, and then it was great because I didn't have the issue of the time anymore, because the more ideas you have, the more you have to think, and then you lose time. Yeah. So you simplified the thing for me, just saying, okay, think of one good example. I actually started from the example. Mm-hmm. First of all, reading the questions, now that is the basic thing, is just to understand it and plan that question, but really thinking of the examples, because at the course, when I got a good introduction from you, and then the paragraphs, the example wasn't really helping me develop. So I first think of the example, and then I just go a little bit backwards. And then that was the click for me, and it helped out completely, because in on the test day, I could check my answers, and I could even count. I counted my words. So, wow. Yeah, so I had really time to spare. I correct myself. Then I had some issues with some words, and then the first thing I did was get in the car with my phone and see if I spelled it correct. And then I didn't spell it correctly. The three things that I was doubting myself, I didn't get it. And then, oh my God, I think, oh, I didn't spell it.
Spelling is important, but you don't have to, if you misspell a few words, it's not a big deal. Like, you're not going for perfection, you know.
All the three things that I could remember that I was in doubt, I didn't get it. And then, oh my God, and the prepositions, I don't know if I did it good. And then it was like this thing until I got the results.
But you got 7.5 overall?
7.5.
That's amazing. Yeah. That's a really, really amazing achievement to go from. So you were getting 6.5 to 7.5. Was that it?
Yeah.
That, on the test that's a huge improvement in what, how long was it? A few weeks or something? Or?
Yeah, it was actually, the first test was in July and the second in December, but I actually just started studying in a month.
So there was a huge amount of information there, Carolina, and I'm really grateful for, I'm not saying that in a negative way at all, but I was just making notes when I was listening to you, and what I'm going to do is just pull out some important things that you did just to summarize them for students. So the first thing was that when you first did the test, you had this attitude that a lot of people have, is my English is probably good enough, it's an English test, I'll be fine. So a huge number of people have this problem where they're like, I can speak English, I can listen to English, I can do this, there'll be no problem. But it's a bit like, I know a few people when they were kids, we live in the countryside, and I have friends who live on big farms, and when they were kids, they would just drive around, even when they were teenagers, before they were allowed to drive. So when they went to do their driving test, they were like, I've been driving for years since I was a kid, I'll be fine. And all of them failed. So because they were not doing it in the way that the driving instructor wanted them to do it. And they were making some key mistakes. And that's the same with IELTS. For a lot of people, even though, like, obviously listening to you, your English level is at a very, very high level, but especially for writing, there are some key things that you might not be doing correctly. Mm-hmm. And that's where the second point I want to make about feedback. Feedback is extremely important. That you said you could get feedback for reading and listening at home by checking the answers, and that's great. But for speaking and writing, if you're struggling, it is important to get someone to look at your writing, listen to your speaking, and tell you where you're going wrong. Because the other thing that I noted down was that you had some very, very specific reasons why you were getting 6 or 6.5. Mm-hmm. So making common grammar mistakes, including lots of different ideas in one paragraph, your examples not being effective. These are things that if you do them, you're definitely going to get a 6 or 6.5. But they're very fixable. It's very easy for me to look at your writing and say, all of your prepositions are wrong, or 90% of your prepositions are wrong. Maybe focus on prepositions. You have too many ideas in one paragraph, just limit it to one thing. Your explanations and examples are not specific enough, or not answering the question. Make them more specific. And that's very easy to go from struggling at 6 or 6.5 to 7 or above. So that was great. And the other thing that I picked out from you was the fact that you were saying that it was from July until November or December. Mm-hmm. And you were like, you knew that you had to improve, but there was nothing really getting you to focus and just sit down and do it. And for most people, there's two things that motivate them to actually do that. And first is fear. So fear that they're going to fail and they're like, oh my God, I have to sit down and actually do this. Or the other thing is when they invest in it. So they invest money in it, or they invest time in it, or they some sort of investment which makes them want to do things. And because free websites like mine are great, but like your husband did, you know, you might look at a few things, it's free, you know, there's no structure to it. But when somebody actually commits to something like you did, which is only $1, then it provides a little bit of structure and a little bit of motivation. And the other thing was you focused on your weaknesses and turned those weaknesses into strengths. So again, focusing on feedback and getting that was amazing. So thank you very much for that. If you could give someone some advice, so we've already talked about feedback. If you could give someone some advice who's struggling with writing, what advice would you give them?
Well, you already said the feedback, that's number one. But one thing that in your course, your $1, I can't believe it was $1, which really, really helped me was actually seeing the good advice. When I just rolled on the comments, and then I saw good example, good paragraph. When you had a positive comment, I would go there and read. Mm-hmm. Okay, what is he doing different than I'm doing? Mm-hmm. And then that was great, specifically in your course. And a thing that I did the most, because I didn't really have time to write as much essays as I wanted to, mm-hmm. but what really helped me was I just planned as many as I could. So yeah. I just saw your website, the things that health, environment, those things mm-hmm. that are the top points. And then I just planned the essay. Mm-hmm. So I had an example. I just knew what I would do in that situation. Mm-hmm. And that helped me having the example in my mind on test day.
So, yeah, I think that's really, really good advice. Obviously, it would be better if you wrote the whole essay.
Yeah.
But a really good just practice technique is to get a bunch of questions, 10, 20 questions. And, you know, maybe you're off on a Saturday or Sunday and you have the whole day, or you have 1 hour a day. Just sit down with those questions and think, what would be the main ideas that I would use for these questions? What would be the explanations? What would be the examples? Yeah. And you're kind of activating those parts of your brain that will for all a multitude of different topics, so that when you are in the test, you are familiar with all the common topics and you've exercised that part of your brain that allows you to figure out, okay, agree or disagree. I agree.
Yeah.
Here's one example, or here's one idea. Here's another idea. Okay, how would I explain that? Okay, how would I use an example in that way? So that's a really, really good technique. Obviously, try to do the whole essay, but if you've limited time, or if you're just worried about idea generation, focus on idea generation. If you're really worried about examples, focus on examples. Get a huge number of questions. If you are worried about paraphrasing, get 20 questions and paraphrase them. You know, it's not rocket science. You know, it's not really it doesn't have to be complicated. If you're worried about something, focus on that. You know, practice in that way, try and get feedback. But even if you can't get feedback, it's good to familiarize yourself with everything. So Carolina, what are your plans for the future now? What will the IELTS test help you do?
Yeah. Well, I'm waiting for it to come by the mail. Yeah, mm-hmm. I just got the results online on Friday. Mm-hmm. I think I will just believe my scores when I see it in paper, you know, because I don't know where those 9 came from. Because at the end, on the second test, I got 9 on listening, 9 on reading, 7.5 in writing, and then 7.5 in speaking. Speaking just remained the same, but I didn't really study, so that's...
I think that you would have got much higher in speaking if you had got some feedback on... Because you're speaking to you, I can't, I, it's, I'd say that you are more an 8.5, actually, just speaking to you today, than 7.5. So again, shows why you should maybe get feedback.
Yeah.
So what will you be able to do on with your, your results?
So I'm applying for the express entry in Canada. So I really needed the CLB9. So that's why the 7 was so important for me. So hopefully at the end of this year, maybe we'll be living in Canada. So that's
excellent. What are you going to do in Canada?
I don't really know yet.
It's nice to have options, though.
Yeah, so I'm a nutritionist, so I would have to validate my diploma if I wanted to work in the area. But I just wanted to move to a country that's better than mine, actually.
Well, if you want a job as a nutritionist, you could start with me. I'd be a big project for you, trying to shed some pounds for me. I think I'm going to have to go on a diet after Christmas. But we all have our own little projects our own little things that we need to improve in our lives. So thank you very much, Caroline. I really appreciate you. I know that's great advice for people, and everything you said is true. And I totally agree with the advice that you gave students. So thank you very much, Caroline. Again, if you need anything in the future, just let me know, and I'll try and help you out.
Okay, thank you, Chris. Because I think the main thing, you were just direct to the point. You know, you do
some
this.
Some people don't like that.
Yeah, but that's great, because it's reality. So the students that appreciate that will do fine. Yeah.
The reason why I'm like that is because I don't believe in wasting people's time. And when I used to teach children, it's really important with children that you don't behave like that, that you don't be brutally honest with them, because you want to instill confidence, and because they're children. But a 35-year-old man who needs the score that they need, just tell them, you're making this mistake, this mistake, this mistake, fix this, fix this, fix this. Some people really like that approach. Others don't. Others don't like me as a teacher because I'm brutally honest with them, but that's totally fine. I can't pretend to be someone that I'm not.
It's difficult to hear the critics, because you want to do fine, but that's really necessary, because if you're struggling with something, then you've got to take action.
Yeah, no, totally.
But then at the same time, I was like, I'm not really prepared. I think my test should be next year, you know. And that is good too, you know, because you just have to do it. Mm-hmm. You're not 100. I didn't feel 100% ready for the test. But I think I never will, you know.
No. Like, so you could work on things for the next year and get 9.999, but why would you want to do that?
Yeah.
there's more important things in life than IELTS, especially after you've got the scores that you need. So well done, Carolina, and thank you very much again.
Thank you, Chris. Bye-bye.